Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Jay Sridhar, Assistant Professor, Agriculture Extension from Tamil Nadu Agriculture University. Today, we are going to discuss about satellite-based communication. We all know satellites are specifically made for telecommunication purposes. They are used for mobile applications such as communications to ship, vehicle, plane, handheld terminals, and for TV and radio broadcasting. They are responsible for providing these services to an assigned region on the earth. The power and bandwidth of these satellites depend upon the preferred size of the footprints, complexity of traffic control protocol schemes, and the cost of ground stations. The satellite works more efficiently when the transmissions are focused with a desired area. When the area is focused, then the emissions don't go outside the designated area, and thus minimizing the interference of the other systems. This leads more efficient spectrum usage. Satellite's antenna pattern play an important role and must be designed to best cover the designated geographical area. Satellites should be designed by keeping in mind its usability for short and long-term efforts throughout its lifetime. The Earth station should be in a position to control the satellite. If it drifts from its orbit, it is subjected to any kind of drag from the external forces. We all know satellites are specifically made for telecommunication purposes. They are used for mobile applications such as communications to ship, vehicle, plane, handheld terminals, and for TV and radio broadcasting. They are responsible for providing these services to an assigned region on the earth. The power and bandwidth of these satellites depend upon the preferred size of the footprints, complexity of traffic control protocol schemes, and the cost of ground stations. The satellite works more efficiently when the transmissions are focused with a desired area. When the area is focused, then the emissions don't go outside the designated area, and thus minimizing the interference of the other systems. This leads to more efficient spectrum usage. Satellite's antenna pattern play an important role and must be designed to best cover the designated geographical area. Satellites should be designed by keeping in mind its usability for short and long-term efforts throughout its lifetime. The Earth station should be in a position to control the satellite. If it drifts from its orbit, it is subjected to any kind of drag from the external forces. With this short introduction, let's get into the principles of satellite communication. Satellite communication systems relevant to fisheries monitoring control and surveillance fishing vessels use satellites that are either geostationary or orbiting. With a geostationary system, the satellite remains in a fixed position relative to a given geographical location. With this type of system, the satellites can at all times receive and transmit messages to any transmitter or transceiver that is within the fixed geographical area visible to the satellite. A communication system based on geostationary satellites may have more than one satellite to cover a greater percentage of Earth's surface. An orbiting communications satellite moves in an orbit so that it passes above a given geographical location at periodic time intervals. Such a system means that Earth-bound transmitters or transceivers come into the satellite's range at these periodic time intervals and transmits or receives only while the satellite is in range or visible. The transmitter may store messages until the satellite is in range. When messages are transmitted to the satellite, they may also be stored in the satellite until the satellite comes into range of receiving Earth's station. Unlike a geostationary system, a single satellite can feasibly cover the whole of Earth's surface. However, there will be time gaps in coverage when the satellite is not in view of given geographical location. Increasing the number of satellites will increase the coverage of the system by decreasing the time gaps when a satellite is not in view of a given location. In both types of system, a fixed or mobile transmitter can be used. Such a transmitter is mounted on a vessel, aircraft, building, and use a radio signal to send a message to the satellite mounted transponder. The message can be stored in the satellite for later forwarding or immediately forwarded to a receiver or transmitter with a receiving capability mounted on another vessel, aircraft, building, etc. In some cases, the receiving station will be largely fixed station which will link to the normal terrestrial telephone system. Applications of satellites. Let us see the applications of satellites one by one. The first one we are going to see is about weather forecasting. Weather forecasting. Certain satellites are specifically designed to monitor the climatic conditions of Earth. They continuously monitor the assigned areas of Earth and predict the weather condition of that region. This is done by taking images of the Earth from the satellites. These images are transferred using assigned radio frequency to the Earth station. These satellites are exceptionally useful in predicting disasters like hurricane and monitor the change in the Earth's vegetation, sea state, ocean color, and ice fields. The second is radio and TV broadcast. These dedicated satellites are responsible for making hundreds of channels across the globe available for everyone. They are also responsible for broadcasting live matches, news, worldwide radio services. These satellites require a 30 to 40 centimeter sized dish to make this channel available globally. The next application is military satellite. These satellites are often used for gathering intelligence as a communication satellite used for military purpose or as a military weapon. A satellite by itself is neither military nor civil. It is the kind of a payload it carries that enables one to arrive at a decision regarding its military or civil character. Navigation satellites. The system allows for precise localization worldwide, and with some additional techniques, the precision is in the range of some meters, ship and aircraft relay on GPS as an addition to traditional navigation systems. Many vehicles come with installed GPS receivers. This system is also used for fleet management of trucks or for vehicle localization in case of theft. The next application is global telephone. One of the first applications of satellites for communication was the establishment of international telephone backbones. Instead of using cable, it was sometimes faster to launch new satellites. But fiber optic cables are still replacing satellite communication across long distance, as in fiber optic cable, light is used instead of radio frequency, hence making the communication much faster. Using satellites to typically reach a distance approximately 10,000 kilometers away, the signal needs to travel almost 72,000 kilometers, that is, sending data from the ground to the satellite and from the satellite to another location on Earth. This causes substantial amount of delay, and this delay becomes more prominent for users during voice calls. The next application is connecting remote areas. Due to their geographical location, many places all over the world do not have direct wired connection to the telephone network or an internet, or because of current state of infrastructure of the country. Here, the satellite provides a complete coverage and there is one satellite always present across the horizon. Global mobile communication. The basic purpose of satellite for mobile communication is to extend the area of coverage. Cellular phone systems such as CDMA and GSM do not cover all parts of the country. Areas that are not covered usually have low population, where it is too expensive to install a base station. With the integration of satellite communication, however, the mobile phones can switch to satellite, offering worldwide connectivity to a customer. Satellites cover a certain area on the Earth. This area is termed as footprints of that satellite. Within the footprints, communication with the satellite is possible for mobile users. These users communicate using a mobile user link. The base station communicates with satellites using a getaway link. Sometimes it becomes necessary for satellite to create communication link between users belonging to two different footprints. Here, the satellites send signal to each other, and this is done using inter-satellite link. Coming to the types of satellites based on the orbits. The first satellite-based orbit is geostationary or geosynchronous Earth orbit, shortly called as GEO. GEO satellites are synchronous with respect to Earth. Looking from a fixed point from Earth, these satellites appear to be stationary. These satellites are placed in a space in such a way that only three satellites are sufficient to provide connections throughout the surface of the Earth. The orbit of these satellites is circular. There are three conditions which leads to geostationary satellites. Lifetime expectancy of these satellites is 15 years. The satellite should be placed 37,786 kilometers, which is approximately 36,000 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. These satellites must travel in a rotational speed of Earth and in the direction of motion of Earth, that is eastward. The inclination of satellite with respect to the Earth must be 0 degrees. Geostationary satellites in practical is termed as geosynchronous, as there are multiple factors which makes these satellites shift from ideal geostationary conditions. Gravitational pull of Sun and Moon makes these satellites deviate from their orbit. Over a period of time, they go through a drag. These satellites experience the centrifugal force due to the rotation of Earth, making them deviate from their orbit. The non-circular shape of Earth leads to continuous adjustment of speed of satellite from the Earth station. These satellites are used for TV and radio broadcast, weather forecast, and also these satellites are operating as backbones for the telephone networks. Disadvantage of geostationary satellites. Northern or southern regions of the Earth have more problems receiving these satellites due to the low elevation above a latitude of 60 degrees, that is, larger antennas are needed in this case. Shading of the signal is seen in cities due to high buildings and the low elevation further away from the equator limit transmission quality. The transmit power needed is relatively high, which causes problems for the battery-powered devices. These satellites cannot be used for small mobile phones. The biggest problem for voice and also data communication is the high latency, as without having any handovers, the signal has to at least travel 72,000 kilometers. Due to the large footprints, either frequencies cannot be reused or the geo satellites need special antennas focusing on the smaller footprints. Transferring a geo into orbit is very expensive. The next is low Earth orbit, called as LEO satellites. These satellites are placed 500 to 1500 kilometers above the surface of Earth. As LEO circulate on the lower orbit, hence they exhibit a much shorter period, that is 95 to 120 minutes. LEO system try to ensure a high elevation for every spot on Earth to provide a high quality communication link. Each LEO satellite will only be vision from the Earth from around 10 minutes. Using advanced comparison schemes, transmission rate of about 2400 bytes can be enough for voice communication. LEOs even provide this bandwidth for mobile terminals with omnidirectional antennas using low transmit powers in the range of 1 watts. The delay of the packets delivered via a LEO satellite is relatively low. The delay is comparable to the long distance wired connection. Smaller footprints of the LEO satellites allow for better frequency reuse, similar to the concepts used for cellular networks. LEO satellites can provide a much higher elevation in polar regions and so better global coverage. These satellites are mainly used in remote sensing and providing mobile communication services. Disadvantages of LEO satellites. The biggest problem of the LEO concept is that the need for many satellites if global coverage is to be reached. Several concepts involve 5 to 200 or even more satellites in orbits. The short time of visibility with a high elevation requires additional mechanism for connection handover between different satellites. The high number of satellites combined with the fast movement resulting in a high complexity of the whole satellite system. One general problem of LEO is the short lifetime of about 5 to 8 years due to atmospheric drag and radiation from the inner Von Allen belt. Assuming 48 satellites and a lifetime of 8 years, a new satellite would be needed every 2 months. The low latency via a single LEO satellite is only half of the story. Once factor are the needs for routing of data packets from satellites to if a user wants to communicate around the world. Due to the large footprints, a GEO typical A geo satellite typically does not need this type of routing as sender and receivers are most likely in the same footprints. The next one we are going to see is about medium Earth orbit satellites, which is called MEO. MEOs can be positioned somewhere between LEOs and GEOs, both in terms of their orbit and due to their advantage and disadvantages. Using orbits around 10,000 kilometers, the system only requires a dozen satellite, which is more than GEO systems, but much less than a LEO system. These satellites move more slowly relatively to Earth's rotation, allowing a simpler system design. Depending on the inclination, a MEO can cover large population, so requiring fewer handovers. Disadvantage of MEO satellite. Again, due to the larger distance to the Earth, delay increased to about 70 to 80 kilometers, the satellite need higher transmit power and special antennas for smaller footprints. The above three are the major three categories of satellites. Apart from these, the satellites are also classified based on the following type of orbit: Sun synchronous orbit satellites. These satellites rise and set with the sun. Their orbit is defined in such a way that they are always facing the sun and hence they never go through an eclipse. For these satellites, the surface illumination angle will be nearly the same every time. Special cases of the sun synchronous orbit are the noon or midnight orbit, where the local mean solar time of passage for equatorial longitude is around noon or midnight, and the dawn or dusk orbit, where a local mean solar time of the passage for equatorial longitude is around sunrise or sunset, so that the satellite rides the terminator between the day and night. The next one is Hohmann's transfer orbit. This is an intermediate orbit having a highly elliptical shape. It is used by geo satellites to reach their final destination orbits. This orbit is connected to the LEO orbit at the point of perigee, forming a tangent, and is connected to the geo orbit at the point of apogee, again forming a tangent. Prograde orbit. This orbit is with an inclination of less than 90 degrees. Its direction is the same as the direction of rotation of the planet. The next is retrograde orbit. This orbit is within the inclination of more than 90 degrees. Its direction is counter to the direction of rotation of the planet. Only few satellites are launched into retrograde orbit because the quantity of fuel required to launch them is much greater than for a prograde orbit. This is because when the rocket starts out of the ground, it already has an eastward component of velocity equal to the rotational velocity of the planet at its launch latitude. Polar orbit. This orbit passes above or nearly above both poles, north and the south of the planet, on each of its revolution. Therefore, it has an inclination of 90 degrees. These orbits are highly inclined in shape. Getting into the factors affecting the performance of satellite communication. The performance of a satellite communication is purely and primarily related to the type and strength of the radio signals used between the vessel, mounted transmitter, and the satellite. The power available in the satellite and the extent to which the satellite can focus on a geographical area are interrelated factors and determine the size and power requirement of the vessel transmitter. The type of radio signal used by transmitters relevant to fisheries, MCS, is usually within the microwave band and as such is highly reliable and relatively low powered. The signal is not greatly affected by atmospheric conditions. So, with a brief note about the satellite communication system and the different kind of satellites and the way how it orbits on Earth, I would like to summarize what we have been through all these notes. The use of satellite technology, particularly in the use of communications satellites, has grown rapidly in the past 30 years. Each day, more and more uses for the satellites are being discovered. Feeding this is the rapid advancement of the technology that allows quick implementation of these uses. Communication satellites will not only help out a person in distress, but also allows a person walking in the street of one country to use their cell phone to speak with someone in another country. More and more satellites are being launched each year to support new and growing uses for the business, military, and communication needs. Satellite communication will continue in the right direction and remains the best utilization for communication due to their speed and other advantages like broadcasting, signal providing in terrestrial uncovered areas on Earth, and independent information transmission irrespective of distance. There are still remarkable technologies to be developed with more powerful processors, new encoding technologies which can make user systems more mobile, more versatile, more powerful in the performance and with low cost. With this, I hope you enjoyed my class. Thanks for listening.